Of our faith, I think, some of some inclusive clubs that it's a foundation of their faith. If we recognize this true way, then it is a creation that we have on this one today. It's actually come out of the truth of God in the beginning, because always existed in God, was saved in his own Son, God, which is always existed in God himself. And so what happened is he was in perfect relationship with the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, which is God, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, that was a perfect relationship. Anyone here ever been close?
Thank you.
themselves. The other side, not being self-centered, inclusive. The other side being racial, like Decapolis, which means Jesus is God for Jewish territory. He's on territory from the God where he knows where he where grew up to Jewish territory. To God, which is the name of Jesus, the wise, which is the name of God, which is Yahweh, or God territory. So he's calling him to a place called Decapolis, which is the Gentile territory, which in Jewish imagination, this is what they thought that was, in Jewish imagination, was the land of demons, of spirits, and a Roman imperial army. In other words, a dark and scary place to go. So Jesus is a thing, I'm calling by God on the side, he's a thing that's got this place, Decapolis, the Gentile is a thing where they have the demons and the spirits and all these types of things. And because we just read the full story, you know, on the way there, a huge big some commentators assert the fact that Jesus may have led them to the Babylon and caused chaos to refine them, to test them, so to speak, knowing exactly how to hold on to God's peace in the middle of chaos, being a clearing trait for them in the coming years. And one of the topics he had literally just taught on himself from our full volume to our friend, the leader, is that he used the parable of the mustard seed, which is saying, don't be more afraid of just me. Very, very unusual space. It's got what's on the side. That's the other side. He was talking about how it was created to himself. Verse 36, and leaving him for them, took him in the boat just as he was, and the other boats with him, and he was mentioning just as he was. Remember that, just as he was. Verse 37, and a great windstorm arose, and the waves were breaking into the boats, and the boat was refilling. Just the context is like this, this great storm. Body of water that Jesus, that talks about on the Sea of Galilee. Now, it's a foundation for the ones that are pictures of the ocean, but neither is a small body of water here. It's actually the largest freshwater lake, approximately 53 kilometers in circumference, about 21 kilometers long and 13 kilometers wide. And more importantly to this story is the information to where this lake is situated. The Sea of Galilee is between 700 feet below sea level. On one side, these mountains are, I think, about 1,500 feet above it. On the other side, it's 1,500 feet above. On this side, there's the mountains flattened out of the crinkle. I think it's the Arabian Desert. We used to call that the Blue Desert before, but I'm pretty sure it's the Arabian Desert. On this side, the mountains are 1,500 miles, and then they flattened out to where Jesus was in doubt is not clear. And so what generally tends to happen in this piece of land, that is the hot air, often the cool air, and it's nothing to be predicted. It is quite unusual for all of a sudden out of nowhere for this crazy windstorm, because that first dollar that is coming from this windstorm to rate. It wasn't just happening this day, it's still to this day now. It has been known that a few people traveling in this area, if this happens, these two winds collide and combine together, and it is known that people don't want for people like to make a Galilee, and their kayak is literally floating. Has come from people wanting to take it away from God. The Greek word, the Bible uses here is Madar, which is the English, which is where we get the English word megaphone. So that this trial is the largest of this last, this is a big storm. But this is big, like it does in the Bible, and it is in the theory of the disciples as well, because they grew up on the big rock. They would have seen received storms, but all of a sudden here the storm, they feared for life. So this is what Mark's trying to conclude. This picture of this is bigger than normal storm that's going on right now. I'm about to consider the Lord for a lot of your life. When in 1 minute you can just be going great, everything's doing well, you've done your job, you're running the job, you're loving the field, and all of a sudden things combine, and there is a great big storm. I'm a parent of a teenager now. My goodness, in an instant, my cars, the pool, the waters, the life can all of a sudden be erupted by this great big storm. It's like it sounds a lot like life for me, and I just wonder if we're smooth on, whether we're seeing the spirit of COVID, finance, kids, and marriage, and medical diagnosis, and good health, and that big stuff fulfilled with waves. Verse 38 says, but Jesus in this letter said, when you should have one kid and said, teacher, do you not care that the person first night, Jesus could have had a beginning to deliver me from his condition. He is
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.